Welcome to the SFCC Library video tutorial on MyBib, a free citation generator. MyBib is a free open source citation generator that will help you create citation in a variety of style formats. It will also provide you in-text citation suggestions. You can download a formatted bibliography. There are options to share or collaborate with others. And you can even create projects that you can save your citations to and come back to for future use. The first thing I do when I get to MyBib is I choose my citation style by clicking on the button at the top center. Mine has defaulted to MLA 9, but there are many other options that I can choose from. Once I've chosen my style format, I can choose Add Citation, and there are two places where you can do that. And then I need to select the source type for the item that I am citing. Here are some popular things that people cite, but you can also click where it says more to see even more source type options. I'm going to be citing a news article from the Washington Post, so I'm going to click news article. Now, I can either enter the information manually by clicking here and then plugging in the information and then hitting save, or let me go back to where it says news article. I can plug in the URL for the article and click search. Yes, that's the article title that I was looking at, so I'm going to hit enter. It says that it didn't see an article author. Was there one? I'm going to go to the source. Yes, there is an author right here, Brian. So let me go back and say, yes, there is. I'm going to type in that information. It then says, oh, we didn't know a date published. So I'm going to go back to the article. Yes, there's a date published, June 8th, 2022. And hit next. And they'll say, well, here's the information that we plugged in. Double check it. Make sure that it looks accurate. Were there any page numbers? Is that the right URL? We are using MLA, so was this the date that you looked at it? I'm going to put today's date. Was that the name of the news source? Yes, it was. If I was writing an annotated bibliography, I could type in my annotation at the bottom. And then what's really nice is they'll give me a preview of what the citation looks like at the bottom. I'm going to click save. And you'll see here, they've already started to format my Works Cited page for me. Here it says Works Cited, and I have my first citation. I can then add another citation and another one by clicking Add Citation. So I've added a couple of additional citations so you can see what it looks like. So notice it still says Works Cited, but they've put them in alphabetical order. They've given us suggestions for in-text citations underneath it. If I needed to make any corrections, I can click on the three dots on the right where I can go back and edit the entry. I can copy the in-text citation, the bibliographic entry, etc. And then if I wanted to, I can click download Works Cited page, choose the way I want to open it. I'm going to choose the Word document right now. It pops up. And you can see that it has formatted it. Everything's double spaced. It's in alphabetical order. Things are indented. If I was working on this with somebody else and I wanted them to be able to add citations to our shared project, I can click where it says share at the top and I would choose on. And then I can email someone or I can provide them a link. Everything that we've done so far has been for free, but if you want to be able to save your citations, so maybe you want to come back tomorrow and add some more citations, or perhaps you have different projects going on and you want to add some more projects, I would suggest creating a free account. I already have, so I'm going to click over here on the top right-hand corner, and it's going to say that I can log in. Now that I've logged in, you can notice on the left-hand side, I have multiple projects that are going on. They've just added the one that I did with the three projects right there. And once again, I can jump around and I can say, oh, let me go into my communications class, look at my citations, etc. Another nice feature, remember when we were on this project, we had three citations. Let's say I realized afterwards, oh, I use MLA 9, but it turns out I was supposed to use APA 7th. I can go up to that style format again, click on it, choose APA 7th, hit save, and it will then change from Works Cited to a reference page, and they've updated all of my citations to APA 7th. So it's easy to switch between different style formats if you need. A few last reminders. All citation generators can make mistakes, so double check your work. And for more citation help, check out our citation guide on the SFCC Library website, or look for more citation video tutorials on the SFCC Library YouTube channel. Citations can be tricky, even if you're using a generator. So if you have questions, please reach out to the research desk or use 24/7 chat with a librarian.